Are Mara and who was it, Azu? Are they coming back soon?
You sent them out. When did you send them out? You sent them out
2 days ago.
2 days ago.
We expect them to be back sometime today or tomorrow, maybe.
I would expect that, yes, someday today or tomorrow. If it came down to it, you could probably ask somebody to send them ascending. Chase would probably know it. Chase might know it. The Father O'Malley might know it. Just to make sure that they get back on time.
Doesn't Falana know it?
Don't we have the stones or whatever?
Yeah, I can say that Casty gave her stone, which she's been hanging on to Azul or Mara, one of the two. And then Chase has the other one still, so you'd have to go to her to actually send the sending.
All right, so Lily's going to do that. She's going to go to Chase early on and send a message out to him, asking him to come back as soon as possible. Something big has turned up.
All right, and they'll get the reply saying, all right, we'll try to hurry. We'll be back early tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Cool.
Hopefully the ship doesn't decide to leave before then.
All right.
Yeah, hopefully it doesn't. What else can we do?
You might want to talk to Surina then, because she's still helping speed up the loading process.
Alana's probably going to pull out her alchemy set and try and make a couple healing potions.
All right. Did we give you an alchemy test for you? I don't recall.
What do you mean test?
Like the roll for
check.
It.
Skill check?
Yeah, there's an alchemy skill check.
Oh, yeah. I'd say you're trying to make healing potions?
Yeah.
I would say roll about 3 checks. All right, about
they're not bad.
About averaging results, not that bad.
All right, I'm back. Sorry.
I'm gonna say with those alchemy checks, you're probably gonna be able to make about 3 normal healing potions.
Hey, 3 is better than 0.
Yeah.
And I think I'm now out of supplies.
Yeah, I'd say you're out of supplies doing all that as well. Alright, so...
You just need a supplies counter to go along with the point counter, so that way mid-dungeon you can keep track of how many potions you can make.
I'm also saying that's going to take a decent portion of the day to make those.
Yeah.
Yeah, this isn't something that you could just do freely. It would take time.
Oh, I know. I'm just mostly joking.
Lily's going to, Lily's going to go to the Baron and see if he's doing okay, basically.
Alright, Lily will go up to the, she'll look around a little bit, and to her surprise, she'll find out that he's actually in his manor, which is not a very common thing for him. I think, I feel like I've said this before at some point. But
he mentioned yesterday when the others were looking for him when the others were looking for him that he wasn't very often in his mansion.
Yeah. Alright, so you'll go up to the manor, she'll actually find him there, and he's kind of going about, he has his great sword in its sheath on his back, and he's going around trying to gather up various things he'll need, and she can actually see as he stands there, he's got this old dusty chest which is opened up. And he's kind of looking through it in there for the moment.
Well, he's going to knock on the door. I assume it's open. And is going to say, hey, you need some help?
He'll look back, you know, kind of sigh. The help I need isn't some that you'd be able to easy provide.
Would it be difficult to provide? I'm good at providing difficult things.
Despite himself, he'll kind of let out a little chuckle at that. Missing the point, as usual. If you're going to be standing there, at least come in.
She'll come in.
All right, and as she gets closer, she'll be able to get a glimpse inside of the chest he's looking in. And looking inside of it, it actually looks like a number of adventuring supplies. Old adventuring supplies, granted, that don't look like they've been used for quite some time.
Is there anything that seems like it's of any use to us?
Why are you trying to loot the Baron's things? Stop.
I'm not trying to loot the
Baron. Because he's currently looting his things. That's why.
I'm just curious what's in there.
No, I just have, No, I just have the image of Lily suddenly reaching over into the chest while the Baron is looking for something and just takes something and pockets it.
No, she's going to actually be more respectful than normal. She's actually... This is odd. Every time the Baron has seen her, she's kind of been a little bit standoffish and, you know, not really respectful of his position. But at this point, she's being very respectful.
Right. I don't think he'll make much of a comment on that yet. What she'll see in the box, she sees a few assortments of long rope, a number of, like, backpacks, other carrying supplies. She sees in there what appears to be a bag of holding as well, which probably has not been used in some time.
Okay. She was going to mention her own bag of holding, but as soon as she sees that, she'll just let him deal with it, because he doesn't need it.
All right, and as time going on, he'll like stand up, or he'll kind of turn his head back and he'll ask, what do you think of these dwarves?
It's a good thing he didn't ask Falana.
He knows better than to listen to Falana in respect to dwarves. Like, Lily, at least he knows, is from an area next to them. So if anyone would know dwarves, it's either Surina or Lily.
Yeah, can you give me a refresher on how Haven looks at Redwall?
Haven and Redwall, they should be allies to an extent, though things can always be interesting for the most part. Let me look at the...
They're allied by words on paper, but they're not close enough friends that they do anything, that they aren't afraid to try and engage in petty war.
Yeah, and they haven't really done anything major recently, but they have been, like, allies on paper, and in times of need they've been, like, more than just on paper allies, though. And they are close enough that a lot of senior nobles from Haven were in Redwall as... Mm-hmm. To deal with things, and so the nobility will travel back and forth to speak to each other. Haven is probably closer than most of the other cities in Haven's area, if only because it's right next to Redwall City, which is their capital.
She's going to say the dwarves are generally trustworthy allies, but they are definitely very skilled in fighting. I haven't spent much time in Redwall, but the time I have spent in there, I know that they're true to their word and true to their blade as well.
And I kind of nod. Yes. Which only makes this more confusing. I would have expected they would have given such a prestigious general more instructions, or more information at least.
Liz's going to say, well... I assume that he probably has more information than he's going to let you know.
I didn't get that much of a vibe from him, to be honest.
Hmm.
All right. At this point, he'll probably like call Lily over and like ask her if she's willing to help him pack things up.
Lily will nod. Anything that he wants her to do, she'll help out with.
All right, and you'll go through, and as you go through, in times he, at one point. It's like you clear out most of the chest, loading a bunch of things into this old bag of holding he has, and at one point he lifts up, it almost looks like a false bottom of the chest, and he kind of looks down, surprised, as though he's forgotten it was there, and sitting in the bottom is a perfect set of splint mail. Like, perfectly polished, despite the fact it's been sitting there for quite a while.
Does it seem to be magical of any sort?
You, I don't think, would know exactly, but the fact it's... when like everything else has like had a bit of dust to it, you know it feels odd, at least.
She's just going to ask for more information on it, because she can see that something's off about it.
And he'll answer, it's just my armor from back in the old days. Though, it might not be a bad idea to bring it out once more.
Well, if he doesn't want it, he could give it to Surina.
I think Surina
already has.
I thought it was better armor. No, okay.
Liz's gonna say that might be wise, even if the dwarves are our allies. You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah,
if Surina was there, she would mention that having the armor on would be a good show of force, would be a good show of pride, and saying, "Ah, no, you can't screw me over that easy."
Yeah,
but not there.
Yeah, and he'll kind of nod. He'll go on to put it all on and everything else. And I expect The two of them will probably spend most of the day there gathering food and supplies. Mm-hmm. Baron doesn't actually have any like servants around the house like Lily might be used to, so he does actually need to go and see the food himself around lunchtime.
Lily would have mentioned to him as well that the dwarves probably would respect his position more if he showed might, like arms and armor.
And he'll kind of, at that point, he'll kind of laugh himself. If you expect me to go in there defenseless, you think a lot less of me than I thought you did.
She's just going to smile.
All right. And as I said, I expect that will take at least most of the day, so we still have... I know we knew what Alana was doing, so we still have Falana.
What's this about me?
What are you going to be doing on the day after the dwarves arrive?
Still going to be scouting them out, because even if they aren't, you know, actively doing anything, we're still going to have to deal with court hands and stuff from the city. I want to basically watch their reactions in regards to the court hands, see if they're trying to be extra secretive or something.
The dwarves themselves do not actually appear to be very secretive. However, as you watch, roll a few perception checks.
Fail it. Watch Surina fall into the water and get distracted.
How many do you want Falana to roll? 3?
She can roll 3, yeah.
Okay.
Because I expect this to be out throughout the entire day, and I'll just use all of them to figure it out.
Okay, went to click on the character. She didn't lock up.
Fun times.
I like to roll 20.
Oh, wait, I just realized the spell I can use now. I'm really happy. I hope I get to use the spell. Except Silver's going to make it. Darn it. Now I'm sad. I'm going to shut up now.
We'll see when time comes.
I do it.
So for the most part, you find yourself getting... like, you can't see that much. There's a lot of dwarves milling about, and there's not too much to see there. However, at one point in the day, you see coming down from the ship is a gnome. And while the dwarves have been rather straightforward, the gnome is being a lot more reserved and hidden about his dealings.
Okay, I'll watch for now. Nothing to really actively do anything on with it yet.
As well as while you're watching on the ship itself, you do notice that the Dwarven General, Oscar, he does seem to spend a lot of time milling about on the ship, and it's kind of understandable. I mean, he's keeping an eye on things. He seems to be very straightforward with dealing with his men. Wanting to be very hands-on with it. Was Serena going to be doing anything else other than just helping out?
If she gets a chance, she'll chat up her old war buddy and see what the hell is going on, if she can get any more information out of him.
All right, roll 2 persuasion checks.
All righty then. Let's see if I can make the sheet cooperate. Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
Good thing you have advantage on these, because he's your own friend. All right, so when you're speaking to this old guy, he'll kind of explain, he'll mention a few things, and he kind of looks around to make sure he's not saying anything else or saying anything too loudly, because it is, as he explains, this is a very, like, the mission itself, he knows, is to, as was explained, retrieve the Baron, and it was the Dwarven Council wished to speak to him regarding, like, how he seems to be overstepping his nobility bounds, and he doesn't know. It doesn't really seem for good or ill. He couldn't tell. I expect if Serena will ask him, like, why they sent an entire warship instead of a messenger, he'll explain that they were also sent to be escort back. And as for why it's an entire warship, well, she's seen what the North is like.
So basically, what I've got on all points, Serena's gonna thank him and say, well, hopefully we don't need to test out the guns too much on the journey.
Is she going to ask about the ship itself at all?
Serena's going to wait until we're actually aboard the ship, because she doesn't want to seem too nosy right now. It's better to wait and maybe see if she can get in good with some of the other ship mechanics instead of her war buddy.
Yeah, that makes
sense.
By
helping out loading.
Yeah, that makes
sense. Because they're going to know more than the war buddy would.
Yeah, and other things that Surina would especially notice because she was there, I don't expect Falana would be able to pick this out with the amazing rules she had. But one thing Surina would notice is, like, for the most part, like, food, ale, all of that stuff, the dwarves are handling that without, like, a single second thought. But more interesting articles, like ore or something that could be, like, even used for any sort of magical properties, the gnome is overseeing that personally.
Huh. Serena's going to go up and approach the gnome, if possible.
And he'll kind of look up at you. What do you need? I have work to do.
I've been assigned by the Baron to assist in loading things up and helping negotiations. Is there anything you need me specifically for?
Go back and help the dwarves. I have everything here under control.
Very well. Yeah, Serena's not going to try and talk to him more because it's obvious this is Crotchety Old Engineer Gnome, and you don't need to piss off Crotchety Old Engineer Gnome.
And as she walks away, she can kind of
find out again.
Oh. Yeah, and as she'll walk away, her old war buddy there is he'll kind of just chuckle, trying to deal with the old coghead.
Some, mostly trying to do my job quite yet, but the ship is interesting enough in and on itself, and gnomish craftsmen are sure to be to know what it's all about.
Yeah, no doubt about that. I don't even understand much about how this ship works myself. I was just told to believe it works, and well, it works, so I've had no reason to doubt it.
Well, one of the big points in its favor is the fact that the hunk of metal actually floats.
Floating isn't the hard part. The fact that it actually moves is impressive.
Well, fair enough. You always didn't know more about ships than I did.
And he'll kind of laugh at that, nodding. Don't expect much more will happen on this day. If you all return back to the tavern, you'll see that it is full of dwarves. You don't think you've ever seen Garrett's tavern this full. In fact, it actually looks like he's recruited people to try to help him serve because there are so many dwarves.
Dwarven drinking games, go!
Alana's going to hang out at the Snippy because no way.
The dwarves themselves don't actually look to be like very snippy or anything. In fact, they look happy to actually be on the ground for a little bit, just even if it's a short while, a little bit of shore leave. And if anything, the only person who looks snippy is Garrett, and that's only because he looks worried about the alcohol stores he has.
Well, he's going to sit down at a table with a group of the dwarves and just small talk with them for a while.
All right. Is she going to be trying to get anything out of them or just have small talk?
Well, at first she's just going to do small talk to try to be a little more friendly, and then after a little while she's going to see what they think about their mission and stuff that's going on.
I'm going to say you're going to be able to get in initially pretty easily with the fact that she can speak Dwarvish.
Mm-hmm.
But roll a persuasion check to see if she learns anything more.
I just realized Serena doesn't even know Dwarvish. She doesn't even know the language of some of her closest allies. Goddamn.
That is quite the persuasion check. And as this goes on, she was asking specifically about their mission, I believe.
How they feel about their mission. She's basically trying to get the sense of the dwarven morale at the moment.
The dwarven morale kind of seems rather decent, to be honest. Like, they'll make a few minor gripes about having to test this new device and being this far away from home, but the morale itself doesn't seem too bad, and when you try to dig more into that, you find out it's because the person they're serving under. They seem to hold General Oscar in very high favor.
She's just kind of going to ask him a little more about the device, hoping that their drinking and her wonderful persuasion check might help her a little
bit.
The
device?
Yeah,
the
device that they were talking about, which I assume is the ship.
Yeah, the ship. And they'll kind of just explain that, or she'll probably get a little bit out of it. They'll say it's that thing. We don't even know what it is. It's some damn thing that the gnomes found and made, or something they made from something they found. We don't know.
She's going to compliment them on their beard.
And one of them will kind of stand up and will kind of bow in appreciation, and then he'll fall over drunk.
I forgot that we were dealing with dwarves for a second, because then I was like, Jeeves, what are you doing? And then, no. Jeeves is right.
What was with that accent?
I don't think I actually gave them an accent right there.
No, but Earth had one.
I'm sick. I get to have whatever bloody silly accent I want because I can barely think straight. Shush.
Alright. Will there be anyone else trying to look more into things, try to figure things out? You'll notice that the general is noticeably absent from this.
Lily's going to ask more about the general, too. If she can get anything out of him.
And it would actually won't be hard to get much out of them, because, like I said, they all hold the general in really high esteem. So they're getting a ton of compliments for him. Like, they'll explain that, the general, he's, well, I remember when he kind of, when old Barthel kind of accidentally left his shoes out, and, oh, man, we could hear the yelling from all the way across the room, all the way across the ship. And, like, it's like that. And as they go on, you get the feeling that the general is probably, if you mess up and disobey an order, he is very harsh on you, but anyone who follows his command, he personally sees to it that they are taken care of. And I'll kind of say, it's like it was mentioned, the fact he's on the ship is the reason that they are in as high spirits as they are, because they, a lot of the other people, like especially dealing, like being under the command of a gnome, you can see that they kind of groan a little bit if that's mentioned, and other things as well. So the fact that they are under a dwarf as well kind of makes most of the crew is in very high spirits.
They know the dwarf is an honest dwarf, and they're happy that they're not serving under some crackpot gnome head who might blow up the ship.
So it sounds like,
is that the gist of the explanation?
Sounds more like the general is a pretty good military general, so she's gonna have her own high opinion of him, I think.
Yeah.
Would Surina know any of this just by from her background? Not anything.
I'm
about
gonna
the ship,
say Surina would know this general by reputation, and she would know that he is very highly respected throughout the dwarvish armies.
Yeah.
I think I've already mentioned that he served primarily in the northern side of the dwarvish army, so he was like right there at the front whenever there's anything trying to attack the
So she might have served under him, or at least alongside, or at the very least, definitely alongside his units. So
yeah, I don't think
so. Surina would know.
I don't think she's seen him personally, but she has at least worked alongside one of his, like, indirectly under his command at one point or another.
All right, then Surina would know. I just want to make sure that Surina actually knows him instead of just accidentally going OOC knowledge.
Yeah, no, she would actually have known him.
Lily would share whatever she gleans with the group as well this evening.
All right, so what's the group's assessment of what they've learned so far?
Did Elana want to do something, too?
Yeah.
Not really, because she personally believes that because she's a kid, they're not really going to give her any attention.
Yeah, one other thing I will say before things go on too far is that at some point in the day, Arashi will come to mention it to Elana and have it spread out to the rest of the group, and he'll mention further on where he's hiding the tank. And he's just saying that he's trying to keep it away from their little prying eyes. And he doesn't really seem to be speaking of the dwarves when he says that.
Crap, be right back. Sorry, if there's anything that you need me for, just skip me over for a little bit.
Alright.
There's only one big thing I see Falana doing for the next couple days, and that's possibly going to bug Chase for just a moment.
Alright.
But no, Alana really doesn't have anything she can do. She did all she could by making the potions.
Yeah, alright. What was Falana going to do? Or is she going to wait till tomorrow?
She'll wait till next day.
Alright. Well, not if there's anything else for today, or we'd be going on to the next day afterwards. It's probably going to be around mid-morning when Mara and Cassidy both return. Or not Mara and Cassidy, Mara and Azul both return.
Lily's going to be at the gates waiting for them, and is going to give a quick explanation of what's going down.
Yeah, Mara herself doesn't seem too terribly surprised, almost as though she's heard something regarding this whilst they were there. Azul just kind of seems to raise an eyebrow. Really, the dwarves are here. I was not expecting a dwarvish army to show up while we left. We probably shouldn't leave anymore.
I was going to say, well, I don't think anyone was expecting that. And she's gonna check on the stuff that Mara was selling and see how she fared.
What all was she selling? I've forgotten.
Oh boy. She's gonna make me remember. Okay. I sent the Tapestry of Winter scene and the silk robe with Mara.
Yes, you sent the treasures with her to sell.
Yeah.
Okay, I should have this over here for me. So I'm just gonna roll to see how much I feel like she's gonna get. Oh, I rolled 91. Good for her. So she is going to, when she returns, she will have sold, how many things did she sell? I don't remember.
I think they're worth about 250-ish each.
Yeah, so she's actually going to return with about 480 gold pieces in hand.
Okay. Okay.
All right, so that's more or less taken care of. And she's back now. You going to say anything more to her? Or?
Should we do Falana's thing first?
Yeah, we could do Falana's thing first.
All Falana's going to do is try to catch her at her house, hopefully.
She's going to catch her at her house, yeah. Chase, you get the feeling when you walk in that she hasn't really left the house much since the dwarves arrived.
You're molting.
She's not actually molting or shedding or whatever the word would be, but she does look concerned.
I'm guessing you weren't expecting the army to show up about, and you're about as pleased with it as I am.
No, I wasn't expecting them to show up. This was quite the surprise.
Something about it doesn't sit right. I need your help. Went on, went through a couple of spells just to make sure I could get the information I need.
What do you need?
You wouldn't happen to have a written copy of Alter Self around, would you?
And she'll kind of nod, yes, that's a fairly simple transmutation spell. I have it right here in my book.
I'm going to have to infiltrate somehow and get into where I can actually get a hold of orders or something like that.
And she'll kind of look apprehensive at that, and she'll just simply say, just don't be careful. We don't want to cause any more trouble than there already is.
The biggest issue we have right now is we don't know exact orders. If it is just retrieval, why would they come in this much force?
I'm back. And are we still discussing why they are...
She's currently with Chase and trying to get the orders from that. And Chase will, at that comment, she'll say, there's more to it than... From what I can see and from what my bird has overheard, and she'll kind of motion to her familiar, which is sitting on a perch nearby. We found that they came here to escort him back, and I can't understand why they would send so many, not so much as to ensure that he comes as to ensure he makes it there. These areas, the waters up north are not safe, especially for a ship that would be carrying that many people.
Then perhaps the land route would be safer.
The land route would take Earth.
Nope.
The land route would take untold amount more time.
Is it me, or does this ship resemble another design we've seen recently?
Roll. That's it? Roll an intelligence check.
Bring it. Oh man, I wish it was an intelligence save. Come on. Come on, scroll down. Thank you. Bring it.
Alright. The ship itself, there are very, very faint hints of other stuff, but it mostly looks like it was made with dwarvish and gnomish craftsmanship. Now then, that's all you can see from outside. You'd have to investigate further to know more. But again, the fact that it is The fact that it's floating isn't quite as surprising as the fact it can move when you don't see any method for it to move. You already basically assume that it's moving with magic, but you don't know how or anything of the sort.
Well, it says it uses uranium rods. What?
Yeah, and when using detect magic, you actually feel like the ship itself is not inherently magic.
But there's points on it.
Yeah, there's a few points. It seems to be more like the below decks, though the ship itself is not inherently magic.
You wouldn't have to have dispel magic in one of your books, would you?
And she'll look through her spell book, and she'll kind of nod. I do, but that one would actually not. That one's going to be more expensive, of course.
Well, I'm aware of that. I'll just have to convulse herself.
All right. Yeah, so that's... I'm going to say she's only going to charge, like, 50 gold to copy it from her spell book, so it'll be 50 gold cost plus whatever that costs for inks.
So, 75 total.
No, it shouldn't be 75 total. That's a level 2 transmutation.
Oh, it's level 2?
Yeah, it's a level 2 and transmutation.
50 total. 100. It's 25 per fire call, right? Or is it 50 per?
I thought it was 50 per.
I think it's 50 per and 25 per for only enchantment.
Yeah, for your school.
Yeah, okay. Then, yeah.
So it costs 150.
If you need gold, come find Lily, because she's got plenty.
I've got it.
Okay.
Alright.
Also, she kind of doesn't want Lily knowing she's getting this.
You're writing spells. What does Lily care?
Yeah. And as what else is anyone else gonna do for the morning and such?
So once all the money and stuff is taken care of with Mara, Lily's gonna say, "What does the bay look like? As for how clean the water is, does it look fairly clean?"
It looks relatively clean.
Lily's going to ask Mara if she wants to go swimming.
Mara will kind of shake her head. Not in winter, she'll say.
What?
You are pretty much in winter right now. And Mara does not want to go swimming in winter without a reason.
Is Surina anywhere near Lily during this conversation?
No, she is not. Well, do have cold resistance items as well that we could let her borrow.
You want her to go swimming with the coat. Or the ring, which is currently on Surina.
See, here's the thing. We're curious. She's curious what Mara would be able to find by looking at the boat from underwater.
Mara does not seem very thrilled with the idea of going swimming in this season, though.
Even if
especially not in the bay.
Hold on. Doesn't Surina have, like, water breathing as a spell? Is that one of her spells or no?
I feel like she would have it. I don't know if she'd have it prepared. Or if it's ritual. It might be ritual, but yeah. Regardless, Jeeves is just talking with
Mara
about this.
I'm just throwing that out there that you might be able to get her to do it. I'm going to check if that's even a spell Serena has. So.
Yeah. And Mara can be like, if you really want someone to go swimming, why not ask the wolf?
That's a possibility. And she'll take Mara back to find Cassidy, and hopefully she's not drunk this early in the morning.
She's not drunk this early in the morning. In fact, she seems like she just woke up, first of all.
Lily's going to say, "Hello, Cassidy. How's your headache?"
What headache?
No headache? Excellent. We've got a job for you.
Yes?
We were wondering if maybe you would like to, go swimming for us.
Why?
There's no oars on this ship. There's no sail. Something's got to be pushing it. I'm wondering if there's something under the water that we can't see.
I suppose I can take a look, though I don't think they would take very kindly to someone looking around.
Yeah, I asked Mara to do it because she can stealth, but...
Mara would pipe up, "I'm not swimming in this weather."
but she's not swimming in this weather. So maybe if you kind of took a swim from further up the bay and then quietly made your way over there, maybe they wouldn't see you.
You kind of be quiet, but roll persuasion.
Can
get it?
Can what?
Roll persuasion. I was gonna say, can Lily offer a handful of gold for advantage? But
no.
Why are you even bothering me?
I'm gonna say no.
Lily has incredible amounts of charisma. She's not gonna need the advantage.
All right, and with that roll, speaking to Cassie, she'll kind of sigh and nod. Yes, I can go take a look. Just stay here. And she's probably going to be gone most of the day doing this.
She's going to say, don't get caught.
Don't have to remind me. And she'll be gone most of the day doing this.
Just better hope that Surina doesn't learn about this, because she's just going to be annoyed that you forced Cassidy to swim in this weather.
She's Cassidy... No, Cassie's going to turn into like a seal or something. It's not going to affect her.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, she's...
Right, I forgot she can do that.
Yeah, she can turn into an animal. Wait, so she's going to just like wolf it up, or not wolf it up. She's going to like turn into a seal or something and swim underneath it.
Okay.
Orca.
Orca, no. Yeah. No, orca probably wouldn't make sense in this close to
too
land.
Big. Actually, yeah, no. I mean, orcas are designed for cold weather. It's just
not in the
too big
area.
Yeah, not in this particular area. It's too narrow and cramped. The seal would make more sense for moving around close. But she could do a penguin.
would actually probably be the best because it's tiny too.
It probably would be the best, to be honest. We'll let Cassie take care of that when the time comes, though. What would anyone else be doing on this day?
I have no idea. Over herself, which I will actually write down later, because I really don't feel like setting that up.
No one?
Got nothing.
Can Lily try to use the last of the mushrooms to craft magical arrows with those effects?
I'm gonna say she can try.
Okay. The effects we have one blind, two fear, three rust.
Yeah, so roll... I'm gonna say she's only gonna really be able to use one set, like one mushroom, but she'll be able to make 20 arrows with it.
Oh, cool.
If it works. So, what one would you want to do? And you're gonna have to roll a few tests.
Let's do fear.
Alright, so that's going to be a smithing test.
Okay, three of them?
Two of them.
Two of them? Okay. Me.
And now, three arcana tests.
Doing good. Doing good.
Okay.
I'm going to say with those rolls...
She explodes into a tiny pieces.
You were using the fear mushrooms, right?
Yep.
As you're working on the mushrooms, you end up making the arrows pretty easily enough. When you're trying to imbue the energy from the mushroom into it, the mushroom kind of blows up in your face, and you run out of the blacksmith shop screaming in terror.
It's just normal day. But she has 20...
And as you're running out screaming in terror, shortly afterwards, the other blacksmiths that are in there follow you out. They don't know what you're running away from, but they know better than to stick around.
If that Lily girl's running away, then you know something's bad.
Like, there's the old joke. Sergeant in motion outranks lieutenant. Demolitions expert at full sprint outranks everyone.
Oh, that's perfect. Lily's our demolitions expert.
Yeah, it's like, so if you see... Like, for in essence, on the ship, if you see a gnome running a dead sprint away from something, you don't ask. You just start running.
So, obviously.
So did Lily end up making arrows?
She did not end up making any of them, no. She made the arrows, but okay. She did not actually manage to imbue them with the magic. And she lost the mushroom in the process.
Okay. Well, I at least have some extra arrows. How much did that cost me?
I'm going to say it cost you the mushroom, obviously, and probably...
The cost of 20 arrows?
Yeah, I'm going to say the cost of 20 arrows.
I'll look that up.
Which I think is like 5 silver at most.
Yeah, it's not much.
All right.
One gold.
Let's see. And who else is left? We still have a Surina for this day and a Alana for this day.
I want Surina to go and figure out if the gnome would have any idea what the symbols would mean. Like, since they're on the tank. But I'm afraid that might get her to have to roll and then accidentally reveal that the apparatus is there.
No. Already from the fact Arashi is very adamant with keeping this thing hidden away from them. And especially that he seems to not be speaking of the dwarves when he mentioned away from prying eyes, because I expect Surina could have probably been there.
Yeah, Surina was there.
So I'm going to say that Surina probably gets the feeling that you don't want to mention this to them at all, if possible.
I know. I'm not. It wasn't anywhere in my plans to do it. But I don't know if there's a way to do it right without it.
And
I
if suppose, you're like, trying oh, wait, to ask the about the sigil itself, the that would again
can we
probably
investigate that instead, or is
you
that
could, but that might lead to other things you don't want to be getting out, like why Damn you it. Know it, depending on how you roll.
Damn it! That's exactly what I was worried about because you know me, I don't trust the rolls.
Yeah, and as you actually, I expect at some point you would have people would have passed through the park. You see where the waygate is? It's actually covered up by dirt.
Okay. So let's not do that, Surina.
And I'm gonna say this much as well: you all get the feeling that this is Arashi's doing with hiding everything regarding the sigil and everything about it.
Oh, I'm going to be lending a hand here.
Then that's actually an interesting thing. Serena's going to go and find Arashi.
All right. I expect you'll find him pretty easily. He'll be standing outside the blacksmith laughing at Lily, who is currently recovering from her bout with fear.
Serena's
going to go over and check to make sure that Lily is actually okay before continuing.
Lily is actually okay.
Liz going to say she's fine. It was just a really scary mushroom.
I think Alana might.
Why on earth
did
you mess with those goblin mushrooms again? You know those cause bad things.
What was Alana going to be doing?
Probably go with Surina to talk to Arashi about why he's hiding all the things.
Yeah.
All right.
Serena's going to go up to Arashi and say, "I know. You probably have a very good reason to hide the big, you know what, but the smaller one in the park."
And he'll kind of just cross his arms and he'll explain. Have you had much dealing with the gnomes, miss?
Not particularly. No. I spent most of my time with dwarves.
Gnomes are an inquisitive breed, I will admit. And they do like... They like to tear apart anything they find in an attempt to figure out how it works. If you were to, say, make a magic rod that shoots lightning out whenever you touch it, including yourself, they would touch it twice to make sure it does it every time. They would touch it three times to make sure it does it every time. They must be thorough.
I like that reference, but Serena's going to say, "Very well, I would rather keep the tank in one piece."
You know, kind of just nod at that. Anyone wishes to roll insight to make sure that he's not deceiving you or anything, and I doubt he would be.
That was my next question.
Yeah, you may roll insights if you wish.
Lily's just going to be screaming and running in circles, so...
It's not the lob tank anymore. It's the mill tank.
God damn it, Risa! You cannot use your free time to rename it at any time you wish. It
Why
is
not?
Not the way this party rule works.
You kind of Arashi just makes a comment. I'm glad we don't actually have its name painted on its side.
For God's sake, there wouldn't be enough paint to get that thing.
At this point, the paint would probably stick out an extra foot with how many times you painted over it.
We just need to have like a line and then tank at the end, and then you just use marker and write in the first part.
Yeah, it's dry erase board in the first part, and then it's got tank at the end. All right, so for what Alana obviously doesn't figure out crap. But Serena gets the feeling that he is very protective of these particular devices, and he does not wish to see them destroyed or damaged.
Of course.
That's interesting. I don't think we have enough time to really investigate this right now, but Serena's going to note that down, make a mental note of that and mention that to the party later.
Lily, since I guess she's kind of in the area, she's going to... ask Arashi to make sure he keeps an eye on these things, as he's already been doing while they're gone.
And he'll kind of nod at that. Yes. And if you do happen to find a way to like some entrance to this way line passageways you found, do send him sending back. I might be able to find my way there with the tank.
Does Alana scream at him for touching her tank?
No.
To be honest, he's had his hands on it a lot as he fixed it up and everything else.
Yeah.
It's either he's protective because he doesn't want to work, try and fix it if the gnomes take them apart, or he's made them. So
another thing to keep in mind is that the gnomes might be able to reverse engineer it, or they might seek for more shit as well.
We don't want them to reverse engineer it. It's ours. We don't want it everywhere.
Because can you imagine the shit they've put on it? These things would become the actual tanks and everything would die.
The only one who gets to reverse engineer anything regarding that is Alana when it comes to Sigil. She's already called dibs on that.
I don't think the gnomes will listen to her, to be honest.
I don't think you get to call dibs on an entire field of study, woman. No.
She is the lead researcher. She has dibs.
Alright.
Dibs don't mean shit. Alright, let's go. We're good.
Fireball means shit.
Alright, I'm gonna expect at some point around now, the dwarf general will, like, you'll see a messenger from one of the dwarfs, and he'll say that the general is, or the ship is about nearly resupplied. The general is going to be intending to leave tomorrow at the crack of dawn. Make sure you have everything finished up before you leave if you're intending to join us.
Okay.
Dawn is early. Lily's going to pass that on to Cassie whenever she gets back, and make sure Cassie's awake at dawn's crack.
You're intending to take all of them with you?
No.
No, we don't need to take everybody with us.
We need a small contingency force, only the four of us.
We're taking Azuli.
I would suggest the Fox and Mara. Cassidy can stay and keep an eye on the town. I mean, the Fox could also stay, depending, but
take the Fox because he's small-sized, and small can get places we can't.
Well, I'm more worried that he's going to get eaten by a hungry dwarf, but...
If you're thinking that, then Cassidy would be a better choice, because she can change into anything.
Yeah, true. She can change into anything. And we also have... Is Chase coming with us, or is she on the council?
She is going to be staying put.
Okay.
She's one of the council.
We also have been taking Cassidy everywhere, so I think we should give her some time off.
Yeah. I mean, you're going to be with that. I mean, that'll just mean Surina focuses on healing instead, so...
What were you saying, Risu?
Chase would also be reverse engineered because she's an oddity.
You don't know how well her excuse of magic is why my body is like this... And there's a reason why she's been hiding in her house pretty much the entire time.
She's an automaton.
Lily would really strongly suggest we take Mara, though, for several reasons. Lily's going to be probably keeping watch over the Baron the whole time, or at least that's her intention. So she wouldn't get too lonely, I don't think.
If I can, let me word it like this. The four of us and the Baron are going to be going on to the ship. That's going to leave this town extremely unguarded. We need as many people here that could actually hold their own in the event something large comes in.
To counter that, Lily has been training the soldiers for quite a while, the captain of the guards here. There's plenty of people here.
Yeah. They also have an entire regiment of clerics.
Yep. They got people.
Yeah, like, this town looks rather defendable, to be honest. Like, at this point, with how things are going, you'd almost question if it would be harder to attack here or Northbridge, because at least, like, in Northbridge, it has better walls, but you haven't seen anything of, you know the military is down south, but you haven't been down south much to see, like, what the military actually does. And from what Lily saw, they're actually not nearly as active or prepared as like it is in Ashenport.
Well, that's right, because the military doesn't have crap going outside right their front door, so...
What we'll do, Ben, is we can take one other. We don't want to travel in too large a group. It's going to tear through any supplies that we personally have. I'm not sure if they're going to be willing to share food or anything with us, so we need to be
minimalistic as possible.
I was going to say, if we're worried about carrying food, we got plenty of rations, so we can always buy more. I'm not worried about that.
I know we do. However, the more people we have, the more we're going to go through.
So we can go buy 50 rations and put it in the bag of holding. That's not going to hurt anything.
Yeah.
There's going minimalistic due to supplies is really not an issue when you've got a bag of holding.
Exactly.
Technically.
Yeah.
What is an issue is if the dwarves feel like we are bringing too many people and feel defensive about it. So perhaps maybe we should talk to the general and see what he thinks.
I would rather not talk to him. If he's here strictly under orders, he's not going to appreciate more than just the Baron being on his ship anyway.
He previously said that we could come with him.
As his bodyguard, as his personal guard. However, I'm pretty sure they're not going to be appreciative if we bring in 50 people.
We're only going to bring in two.
Yeah, we're bringing two at max.
It was an example.
I say we should bring Azuli and Mara.
I'm okay with that.
Serena's fine with that, too. Serena would want to stay because she's the one who's got the best night vision and best forms to deal with scouting out in case something bad happens while we're all away.
Lily's also, Alana has an idea on how to get Azuli on without people getting really upset.
Lily's going to talk to Cassidy when she gets back and suggest that she try to stay sober.
Yeah, are we going to pull a poor little waste-only friend in the world pet routine thing?
Yeah.
Yes, we're going to pull the fact that Azuli is the fox and he's our pet, and he is Alana's pet.
Right, while this is going on, by the way, while you're finishing up your discussion, Cassidy will return, and she'll kind of just walk up to the party and see what's going on.
Serena's right. Going to say, we're heading out at the crack of dawn. You get to stay here if you don't want to come with us.
She'll say that's... That'd be fine to stay here and keep an eye on things. It'd be odd to go too far away from home.
Liz's going to point out that we're depending on her to ensure that everything remains in one piece and safe. So the less time she spends completely drunk, the better.
She'll kind of give a little nervous chuckle at that, but... Oh, no, we lost Alto.
Did we lose somebody?
No, hey, Alto, you there?
Alto, no!
Hang on.
The poor cute girl gets too cute for this world. No.
I think we should take the fox, put it in Alana's backpack, and just kind of have the ears and the nose poking out, and that's it.
Okay. One other thing I want to say here and now. I repeat myself or type it out to Alto here on Skype or something. Oh, well, yeah. I'll type it out for Alto.
Yeah, about the crush. No. Yeah.
It's going to be a little while before Alto comes on, so I'm going to go ahead and say it now.
Yeah.
One thing that I am concerned about is there is something really fishy about these dwarves being here in the first place. I'm not sure if it's the general himself who came up with the idea, or if he's received orders, but somewhere in there, there's some line of corruption that needs to be dealt with.
Well, he's going to mention that she heard that there were orders given out.
Which means we need to find the source of those orders and figure out what's going on. You don't show up in an armed prototype warship.
Well, he's just going to interrupt at that and say, I think it's been said several times that, that there's a reason why they're here in an armed warship.
Yeah, because they received orders. Have you ever been sailing in the waters of the north? It's full of monsters. Really dangerous monsters. It's not something you traverse lightly.
Then why sail? Is that bad?
Because it's going to take three times as long to walk.
Because it's longer over land and it's less of a safe route. At least by sea, they have a big, shiny, dangerous warship that they know can kill most of the things in the water. And they can send it in a week instead of a month.
This is the best way for them to do what they're trying to do.
Something feels really fishy about it. The fact that they honestly were going to use force? Something fishy.
They weren't going to use force, as far as I'm aware.
No, they probably would have decided to use force if there was resistance, and only on the Baron, to get him to come with them.
Yeah, the Baron or anyone directly in the path. Like, obviously, if the Captain of the Guard stood in the way, they weren't just going to take it. They probably would have beat him down. Probably wouldn't try to kill him, but they would have beat him down out of the way and gone to the Baron directly.
But Lily's going to say she doesn't think that they want the Baron dead or harmed in any way. But that's why she's going to keep an eye on him.
Either way, we do need to get fair orders, figure out who's demanding the Baron. There's no need for Redwall to require the Baron at all.
Alright, and still waiting for Lily to ask Cassidy what she found.
Yeah, Lily would probably take Cassidy to her room. And ask,
why not right here?
Because the party. Because I'm assuming that we're in a public area. And Lily would ask in private what she saw.
Going to be doing, we'd be in a room anyway where no one else can hear us.
Alright, well, let's assume we're all in our rooms then while we did this whole thing. And Lily's going to ask the fox what she heard, what she saw.
I heard the other wolf. What Cassidy found is she explained that along the bottom of the ship she saw like a rudder, pretty obviously, but stranger than that, it looked like, just to kind of stop and try to think how to explain it, kind of, you know, the thing that Garrett has to, he screws in and pulls out the bottle caps, his wine bottles with?
Cork?
Kind of like...
corkscrew?
Yeah, corkscrew. It kind of looked like a corkscrew on the bottom. Two of them. One on each side.
Oh, can I corkscrew propeller. Although, that? Obviously, Serena doesn't say that.
Can I intelligence check that?
You like, may.
What kind of effects it would do underwater?
What it might what?
Like, what kind of effect it would have underwater?
You can, intelligence check on it. What you know is that, like, first of all, water mills and such, it's not that uncommon to see a corkscrew or as like a type of water wheel, and you could make the assumption that they're using this, like, if it's spinning under its own power, it would push the water out of the way and propel the ship forward.
So there must be a spot inside where a whole bunch of dwarves are cranking this corkscrew. That's what Lily's going to think.
You could power it with magic in theory.
It would probably be pretty intensive to try to continuously power that with magic.
It's not impossible, though. There are other ways as well.
Shut up, phone.
No, your phone doesn't want to shut up.
I had to wait for it. It was the perfect timing. It has to happen once per session.
Alright, well, why am I getting a message saying call ended?
It's because Alto's coming back now. Is Alto here now?
Sorry.
Alright,
we blame you.
Stuff that I know you missed. Cassidy making a report of what she found. On the bottom of the ship, there was obviously the rudder and two corkscrew propellers.
Alright.
It's propulsion. They're basically pushing the ship along with that.
Yeah.
Yep.
And Falana said once again that she doesn't trust anything.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise anyone, though.
Nope.
And I think Falana wanted
to... simple situation.
You wanted us to look for whoever's giving the general orders to?
Yes, we need to figure out who's giving the orders, because it is a rather unusual order, no matter how you look at it.
Yeah. At some point while you're discussing this, you'll get a knock on the door.
I was gonna say, who is it?
It's actually Garrett.
Him in.
They're kind of psyched. Come on, lass. I don't need to actually speak to you. The Baron wanted to. I was just passing it along.
Okay, well, right, let's open the door.
Meet up with Baron.
Yeah, and Serena would. Damn it. Never mind.
Right, and he'll step into the doorway, but he doesn't actually come into the room. I think it was down. Actually, he was up at his mansion last I saw. But yeah, he wanted to speak to you, figure out who was going to be joining him tomorrow, since it looks like you're going to be heading out first thing. Ah, the whore. I won't be able to see such pretty faces. And
all right, grab
I'm not
going to
finish the comment.
And I'm going to take some rope, wrap
so
it around
Serena's going to lean down and pat Garrett on the head. I know you don't particularly like scales, Garrett, but thank you for being kind anyways.
He's going out.
Oh, you're the one I have trouble with. I'm gonna leave now.
Good idea. Come on.
Take the rope.
And he's sprinting away at this point, laughing.
Another battle skirt comment.
Anyway, let's go meet up with the Baron.
He was skirting the battlefield, you could say.
The battlefield and not getting kicked in by Lily. Anyway.
And the Baron is kind of... He's in his mansion. You see... Yeah, when you get there, I expect you'll walk up to the mansion, up the path. The front door is unlocked, though it's not opened.
Yeah, Lily probably will be taking point, I'm guessing, because this is kind of her thing that she's...
Yeah.
Nobles do what nobles do.
Yeah.
Go for it.
And she'll knock on the door. She'll call out for him.
And he'll respond, "Come on in."
She's also going to mention she's got her friends with her.
Yeah, and he'll still mention, "Come on in." And when you open the door and you step inside, you'll see that he's currently near one of the side doors by the staircase that leads up to the second floor, like the balcony. No, it's a big foyer type area. And he's kind of just making sure that his armor fits everything, is taken care of, his sword is well maintained, everything else is ready. He's got like a bag of, you recognize it's his bag of holding. It's sitting on the side of the table he's on, and he's making sure everything is prepared.
Lily's going to say, "You called for us?"
"Yes. I wanted to see how many of you actually intended to join me."
"It's going to be us four and our friends Mara and Azul."
"Yes, I think I've met that fox before. Do you trust him? Her? It?"
"As much as fair you can trust a fox."
"Eh, a fair reply.
They're fairly trustworthy, I feel.
They're tricky, if nothing else.
Whoever it is will try to cheat you out of a game, but they'll help you in other matters quite happily."
"All right. You just have to know what price to pay."
"Well, I was going to say, the one thing I can vouch for is Azu is a great fighter."
"Hopefully we won't need that, though. You never know. It's actually odd. I recall the last time I was even near Redwall that the one who summoned me was still considered the old counselor there. I would have thought they would have passed away by now."
"They're still alive."
"Is it a dwarf? Dwarves can live for quite a long time."
And it looked at Surina. "This was already an old dwarf. I believe Amber has led the council for an untold amount of years."
"Suspicious."
Liz's gonna ask him if he has a better idea of why he was summoned.
"Political garbage is why. They take some of the nobles, you must have had dealings with them, Lily. Most of the nobles take offense when one oversteps their boundaries by even the smallest of degrees. If they were to own land even 5 feet more than they should. I believe that it's obvious that I have control over much more than I should, and these nobles have finally taken notice and offense at it."
"Well, then maybe you should no longer be a baron. Maybe they should give you a higher title. You're obviously doing the work of more than just a baron."
He'll kind of sigh at that, but nod. "That would probably be the most ideal solution, though.
Without
I don't really wish to take much of a higher nobility ranking. If anything, it'll remind them that they couldn't pull this crap out of the fire."
"Yeah, that could lead to a technically a war, so let's avoid that."
Liz's gonna cross her arms and say, "You've been asking for months, if not years, for people to come to your aid, and when finally someone has, they've pulled this crap on you?"
You know, kind of chuckle. "Yes, they did. Now, if everything goes well, we won't actually have to fight any of them, but it's been so long since I've been in Redwall."
"I do suspect there is some kind of corruption involved here."
"Potentially." And he'll kind of reach onto his little table he's on next to him, and he's going to grab a letter, and he's going to hold it out to Lily.
Lily's going to take it.
In the event that I am very quickly taken to talk to the council directly when we get there, take this letter and find a dwarf by the name of... I should have had his name ready.
Good job.
Oh, you severely underestimate my preparation skills.
I'm surprised you just didn't pull one right out of your head right then.
Yeah. I didn't have one ready, to be honest, or I would have. I didn't even have dwarf names in my head. Find an old dwarf by the name of Fargrim. I used to know him back in years past, and last I knew, he was a sturdy ally. He might be able to help you out. I don't know things about the area, if nothing else.
Lily's going to nod and say, we have no intention of starting a fight with the dwarves, but I will ensure that no harm comes to you if there's anything I can do about it.
I kind of chuckle at that. Don't make promises that might put you against an entire army.
It was my charge.
Wiping out an army small enough.
She's going to say, it was my charge to help you. That's what I will do.
Very well. Regardless, that is everything I really needed to speak to you with, or speak to you about. We should all get to bed early so that we were prepared to leave in the morning.
All right. Give me a moment. I hear a cat whining. I need to look into it.
Okay. I really hope
it's,
I took care of the
Lily.
Map, right?
Lily's the whining cat.
He's also going to make the comment that you should probably get a hat or something to hide those ears.
She has a
cloak. The dwarves are going to be...
She has a cloak.
That'll work, probably. And that'll be it for this. So everyone going to head back to the room to get a night's sleep?
Yep.
Lily will ask the Baron if he needs anything else from them and offer to stand guard at his place if he's worried.
He'll kind of shake his head with a bemused expression. No, I'm not worried about my own home. I'll see you all in the morning.
All right. Lily will follow the rest.
All right. And night comes, you all rest, and you're all woken up fairly early on. It's actually Garrett who wakes you all up, making sure you're all prepared. As fun as he is, he doesn't seem to at least take something seriously.
Lily's going to flip him a gold coin as thanks.
And he'll take a gold coin. Remove a gold coin from your inventory.
Yep.
And a lot of you with Azul and Mara assemble. And when you actually go down to the bottom of the hotel, you see Mara is, first of all, already awake, and she's speaking to someone else in a second who hands her a package and then dismisses himself.
What's that?
Mara, wasn't expecting you down so quickly. It's a new weapon for the long journey ahead. The old one was getting rather worn out.
Okay. Is it magic?
You kind of just chuckle at that and it got prepared to, like, load it up so it's prepared to take. And as she does so, she does it right, like, pretty close. If not in the inn itself, then out. It's another heavy crossbow. It looks more ornate, granted, and shiny, but it's just another heavy crossbow.
So it's not magic? She just bought a new one?
You don't know.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Or do we?
It's magic.
And a lot of you...
Oh, it's magic.
The lot of you will assemble outside on the docks of the ship, and... You see the general is down there waiting for you. He'll kind of nod to everyone assembled, and they'll ask, these all bodyguards for you?
Alana's going to be holding Azuli in fox form. Just kind of, like, absentmindedly petting him.
I honestly wasn't expecting to see a child in her pet.
Hey. Rude.
Lily's going to say, this child has magic that has aided us very well. And normally we wouldn't put such a young person in danger, but we do have a cleric that is very skilled in keeping her safe.
And you'll kind of look at Lily as she says this, but nod. Fine. Very well. Now then, a few rules to start off with. We will not be taking your weapons from you. The things are dangerous enough, and it would be troublesome if you weren't able to aid us if we were attacked. That being said, if you attempt to harm me or any of my men, you will be locked up in chains for the rest of the journey. Am I understood?
We have no intention of harming you.
Makes sense.
You know, kind of nod that. All right, very well. Onto the ship. We'll be leaving within the hour. And he'll go up onto the ship. All right.
Is the Baron nearby?
Yeah, the Baron was with you when this happened.
Okay. Yeah, Lily's just gonna stick with the Baron, pretty much from now on.
All right. I was gonna use Girl Azul or Boy Azul.
Girl.
Okay, I'm back.
Sorry.
That's this cat wanted to go into her room.
Yeah.
You said there was a whining cat. I said it was probably Lily.
Yeah. All right. But yeah, the Baron was there with you. Do you want to speak to him?
Lily's just going to basically turn into a guard at this point. So right. She's going to pretty much just stand at attention and wait for him and follow him.